Well, I feel like just being from Africa, you know, we have a lot of pride in what we love. So definitely, if you're an African in the NBA, you love the sport, have a lot of pride in it. You know, a lot of players like Pascal Siakam, Serge Ibaka, OG Anunoby, Bam Adebayo is African. So, you know, we just take a lot of pride in our sport. You know, I definitely look up to them, model my game and lifestyle after African players in the league. I'm trying to, you know, be successful like them as well.
Question for Felipe.
Hi, Onyeka. How are you? Felipe Romo from Grupo Legado, Mexico. With all the training time since the pandemic, what can you say are the biggest differences between the Onyeka of a few months ago and the Onyeka that we're going to see in the NBA?
Definitely. I just feel more confident about everything in my game. You know, I feel better shooting the ball, feel better handling the ball. You know, I'm learning different things on and off the court just to be better as a man. So I'm about to be a 19-year-old player coming into the NBA. So definitely, I'm learning things off the court to help me better myself going into the NBA.
Thank you, man. Good luck.
Question for Jason Anderson.
Hey, Onyeka. Thanks for your time today. Have you had any, I cover the Kings in Sacramento. Have you had any interactions or in-person workouts with them?
When it comes to asking me if I've interviewed or worked out with any teams, I have to go right to my agent for that one. I keep that information disclosed, and I don't tell anybody that to the public. I don't.
Okay. Thanks anyway. And good luck.
Thank you.
For Florenzo Henry.
Yes. Can you hear me? Hi, Onyeka. Nice to talk to you. My question is simple. You have great physical abilities, especially to defend on bigger player, like just a five player. Did you, however, feel in trouble sometimes defending on some players this season? And which one, if it does?
Nah, honestly, I feel strong enough holding my own weight against bigger bruisers. Obviously, people are going to score, but like overall, no one really outworks me, outbattled me. I just feel like my physical gifts help me. It helps me against big bruisers, and I move well on my feet to guard smaller players. So definitely throughout this whole season, I don't feel like anyone really just absolutely dominated me this season.
Okay, thank you.
Question by Chico.
Hey, Nick, how are you today?
Yeah, how you doing?
Not too bad. So in high school, I think it was your first year of high school at Chino Hills. You got to play alongside LaMelo and Lonzo Ball. What was that experience like, and did it have any impact in your development as a player?
It was fun playing with the Ball Brothers. I've known the Ball Brothers since I was 10 years old. I remember me and Melo used to watch Chino Hills play all the time. I with my older brother and Alonzo on the team. So definitely playing with them my first year of high school was fun. And playing with them, I just learned how to rebound the ball a lot, defend a lot, block a lot of shots, rim run. So all the things I learned from my first 2 years really translated to the rest of my life playing basketball. The ending years in high school and going into college, you know, all that stuff I learned my freshman, sophomore year translated.
Thanks, man. Best of luck.
Thank you.
Question by Justin Quinn.
Hi, Onyeka. I cover the Boston Celtics, and there's been a lot of speculation that Boston would be interested in dealing up to get to your projected range. Have you thought about your potential fit with a team that is going to be trying to contend?
A player like me, I feel like I can fit anywhere. No matter what team or in the NBA, I feel like I can fit anywhere due to my versatility defensively and my offensive upside and potential. Playing with Boston, you know, you have players like Kemba Walker, Brown, and Tatum. You know, I definitely feel like if I was ever to be drafted by Boston, I can definitely fit in with that young core they have.
Thanks so much.
Question by Rob Schaefer.
Hi, Onyeka. Thanks for doing this, man. I'm just curious, kind of, what are the things, like, where have you been based as you've been working out, doing pre-draft stuff? And what have you been working on, kind of, like, adding to your game and things of that nature?
Well, I'm from Los Angeles. I was working out closer to, like, Beverly Hills. before I moved out to my hometown in Chino. That's where I'm at right now. But this all whole offseason, I've been working on ball handling and shooting alongside what I do well in, because I haven't played a game since March. It's November, so it's been a long offseason to get better. So I've definitely been getting better in everything as a whole.
Thanks, man.
Question by Kevin Gay.
Hi, do you hear me?
Yeah.
Thanks. During the off season, which point did you mainly work on? Maybe the shooting?
Can you repeat that question, please?
Which point was your main goal, to work on during this off season?
Definitely ball handling. That was my main point of emphasis. I never really worked on ball handling before. And now that these past 7-6 months, I've just been working on that every single day when I trained. I really feel comfortable ball handling the ball alongside shooting and doing other things well. But definitely, I prioritize ball handling for sure.
Thanks so much.
Question from Christos Staltes.
Hello, Onyeka. First of all, you are in the mock draft through the top 10 picks, one of the top 10 picks through the mock drafts. What it means for you, and what are your expectations about next season? Maybe the Rookie of the Year trophy is back on your mind.
Just tell me into next year, man. I just want to be able to get better and be on whatever team drafts me, be able to be impactful, help them win games, and just, you know, start off my career right. You know, accolades, they're all good, but winning and being impactful and being a good teammate is even better.
Question by Rod Beard.
And you could get, given some of the uncertainty at the top of the draft, and some places have you going as high as 2, as low as 8, is that sort of nerve-wracking when you think about, you don't know where you're going, but it could be here, it could be there, it could be high in the draft, lower in the draft. Do you think about that, given that there's so much more time?
No, I don't really think about that. No, obviously, mocks are going to happen. People are going to tag me and stuff on social media, but I don't really give into that. Wherever I'm projected, but just as long as I'm selected, I'll just accept wherever I go. And I'm not nervous at all, happy for where I go. I'm excited for everything that's about to happen.
I know you said you think you can fit on any roster, but given what the Pistons seem to be in that range of teams that could look at you, have you thought about what that fit could be like for you?
I feel like I can fit in well. No, I can definitely play alongside Blake Griffin. They have a lot of young players on that team. Definitely be able to, you know, be in that mix and help them defensively, offensively. But definitely be a defensive anchor, though. One team that really needs help defensively. I definitely know that I can be impactful for the Detroit Pistons.
Do you see yourself as a center or a power forward, or maybe a little of both?
Both. I'm 6'10", so I can definitely play the five, small ball five. And I move well. I'm versatile enough to play the four, so whatever the coach wants me to play, I'm going to play.
Appreciate it. Good luck to you next week.
Thank you.
Question from Dan with the LA Times.
Hey, Onyeka. Kind of two questions for you. First of all, you mentioned, you know, growing up with LaMelo and, you know, knowing him since you were 10 years old. You've seen his journey go from Chino to Lithuania to Australia. what's it been like kind of watching him zigzag? And I guess secondly, when you watch the modern NBA, do you see elements of yourself in any players, or are there any guys that you're like, that's how I think I can impact games?
Well, first, you know, I'm just happy for LaMelo to be where he's at right now. You know, Melo's a great kid. You know, he's been to so many different places in life. He's only 19 years old. So I'm just happy he's able to live out his dream just like me and be an NBA player. And as of right now, I just want to be a player like Bam. You know, Bam's my size, same athleticism. You know, it took him a while to really be that all-star player he is in year 3. So definitely, you know, I can definitely do that whole development process and be a solid player like Bam is.
Is that where the ball handling work and stuff comes from, like watching the way he kind of initiates offense?
Yeah, definitely, because at Kentucky, he wasn't really doing all that he does now. So it took him time to develop, and I can definitely do the same thing for myself.
Question from Mark Berman.
Yes, so more of a broad question about not having a summer league and a lot of time to work out with your new team. How much you think that's going to affect your this rookie class, with the way it's shaken out?
I think we'll all be good. We have a lot of talented players in this draft class. We haven't played a game since March. We're all hungry and anxious to play. So I know me and the rest of the players are excited to get on the court and play against some of the best talent in the world. So I don't think it's really going to affect us at all because we're hungry to play already.
Thank you.
Question by Rick.
Hey, Nyeka. The way that you demonstrated an ability to switch, the way that the NBA defensive styles are seem to be shifting in that direction, how do you think what you do best fits into where the NBA is headed defensively?
Well, I can definitely switch on screens. And I'll move well on my feet. And I have great lateral foot speed for someone being 6'9", 6'10"-ish. Definitely being able to switch is going to help me a lot and give me an edge on other defenders that are like my size but have slower foot speed.
Thanks.
Thank you. Right, and we'll go to one final question from Chase Hughes.
Hey, man, obviously, you know, going from college to the pros, there's going to be some adjustments defensively. What do you anticipate being kind of the thing that you have to work on to make sure that your skills translate quickly on that end of the floor?
No, defensively, I feel solid. No, I'm definitely going to be able – I'm able to, bang down there at the big players down there and play with some of the shiftiest guards in the world. But I'm confident in my abilities to hold my own, be able to – and guard bigger players and guards fast, shifty players. Now I'm very confident in my ability to do that.
All right, thanks everybody. We'll ask you to exit the meeting so we can get on with the next part of Onyeka's schedule.
Thank you guys.
Thank you, Onyeka.
Thanks, Onyeka.
Thank you.